So this is for Gabriele, who wanted to have another match with the red deck wins. Hi, good luck, have fun. Let's see if we can win. Actually, we are on the draw. Let's see what we're up against. It's Swag Warrior. Let's see what he plays. We joined the game on the match, so it's possible that he doesn't expect a player to join that soon and just takes his time. Maybe he's not even online anymore. Let's see. Oh, there he is. This hand is not so good just because the cohort doesn't do anything on its own, and the heal cutter is pretty late. We just keep because we can kill one creature if he plays one with our chain lightning. Let's see what happens. So there are the cliffs, and this should be Peregrine Drake. Another cohort, so I just play chain lightning for three, which is not the best option here, but let's do it like that. Later on, he has two red mana on its own, and we don't want to have him that mana because if he copies the chain lightning, he can just get rid of one of his our creatures. There's a preordain, which is nice because that means that he's digging for lands and that he doesn't play anything else. No, I want to play. Oh, there's a second land, which is blue, not red. We've got our third red mana, and I hope we don't draw any more red mana spells. And next turn, we have to hope for him playing a Seagate Oracle, which we can burn with the lightning bolt, and then we can attack with two Mud Brawler cohorts, or we can just play a dashed heal cutter. Both options are good. Let's see what happens. I'd rather go for the cohort because we've got four damage done, which you also have with the heal cutter. I'm not sure yet. So this is a burn spell that he has in his hand, and he uses the Boilerworks. What does he put back? Okay, so he's got the lightning bolt in his hand, and I think he's going to burn one of our cohorts, and those cohorts are bad again because they only deal one damage. So this was not a perfect start, since we only deal one damage. We keep our lightning bolt for getting rid of the opposing creatures, and there should be a Peregrine Drake soon. What is that? It's a Seagate Oracle. I don't kill it yet because we've got the heal cutter. If it doesn't work playing the heal cutter, we can just lightning bolt it. Let's see, what is better? Is it better to dash it or to play it? I think it's better to play it. Let's play it here. Could have played the lightning bolt to be safe from burn spells. Let's see what happens. I hope he doesn't have a burn spell. No, he doesn't, I think. Oh, he doesn't have haste. Oh, this is a bad. This is so bad. Okay, so he kills the heal cutter, and we are way behind. He's a controlish build, and we are a fast deck, and now we are losing against him. There's another Seagate Oracle that he plays here. Now it's just Compulsive Research, which is good on its own because it's three cards, and he's digging for some answers, or he's digging for his combo. He got rid of the Boilerworks and has a second land, so now he should have a burn spell. And if I were him, I would just attack. No attack here. Upkeep. We draw another land, I think. Let's see. I hope we don't. Okay, there's a stop in our upkeep, so he's thinking about burning the Mud Brawler. What is he thinking about? Oh, and there's a burn spell, which we don't really need, but we want to get rid of the Seagate Oracle. Since we have a second lightning bolt, it's not too bad to get rid of that. No. We should have gotten rid of the Seagate Oracle last turn. Would have been better. Way better. Let's see what happens. So I was thinking about playing a counterspell at this point of the game, but he doesn't, so let's attack. Question is, do we want to play a mountain now? I think we don't want to play a mountain now, because we can play it later on as well. So there's third lightning bolt, and now we are without pressure. No pressure at all. Yes, this is good game. So there's the Seagate Oracle from his side of the battlefield. And he's got five cards in his hand. One of them should be a counterspell, so we can't do anything about it anymore. Let's see later on what the sideboard brings. Let's chain lightning this one. And I think we could concede here at this point of the game. There's, what is that? Is it a counterspell? Is it a flicker? If he flickers that one, yeah, let's concede the game. Let's have a look at our sideboard. So we don't have really much to do about his deck. We could want to have the Flame Slash to get rid of his blockers, but I'm not sure if we need Flame Slash. No, Flame Slash is not as good. We can get rid of the Chain Lightning, Flame Slash, or Smash. Smash is not so good. Electricity. Yep, we want to have these creatures. Do we want to have that one? Yeah, it's okay. I'd like to have more fireballs. Yes, I want to play first. And this hand is not so good as well. We have no one mana creature, and that one is bad as well. Let's keep. Put on top. I want to cast the Bushwrecker now, just to have more damage here, because it doesn't make sense to wait too long for our creatures. It's just a matter of 2 or 3 points of damage, which he will deal in the long run here as well. So we don't have any removals, so we have to be careful. Let's play the Valley Dasher and attack for 3. And next turn we play the Jackal Familiar. Doing as if we had a burn spell. So he gains 1 life. There is a cohort, which is nicer than the other one. Now we have 5 damage. We dealt 5 damage. And next turn we just attack with all of our creatures again. He should have either a removal spell or what is it called? The blocker. I guess he's playing the blocker now, blocking my Bushwrecker, which is okay. No, he doesn't have anything, so he has a counter in his hand or something like that. And we have the second Fire Blast, which we actually do not need at this point of the game. So there's a lightning bolt for this one, I think, or that. Guess it's the Dasher that he wants to get rid of. No, it's the card. So we deal 3 damage this turn. Yep. But we have a familiar, which is a nice replacement for the card. And he's got a counterspell. Maybe we want to have some pyroblasts against this deck. Or what else do we want to have? Maybe some land destruction to get rid of the swift autoclaves. Not sure about that. So we have, nice. We have a haste creature, which is he is going to counter. I think he has either hydroblast or a counterspell. But I want to play it before combat,
so that he taps out. You have to play it before combat because it's haste. There goes the dasher, and now we are in a pretty bad spot again. I think mono red is pretty fast out of gas. It's not as good as I thought it was would be. Let's see if he can play this one and attack. I hope he doesn't have any. Any burn spells. What does he have in his hand? Maybe it's a Peregrine Drake. Yeah, could be. Okay, so he doesn't play anything. Maybe he's got a counter spell. Let's see. Oh, nice. This could be good game here at this point in the game because we've got two fire blasts. I still wait one another turn. So he's got 6 mana. What else does he have? Let's yep. Cast with kicker. And then I still wait one more turn, just to play it safe. Okay, so he's got 3 cards now. Does he play a land card? Let's see. Does he have removal? No. Let's see what happens. There's a land. I don't play the land yet. What's that? It's a Hydro Blast. Flickering the Swift Water Cliffs. This is what he does. Cancel. He's got to have 2 counter spells. Oh, he's going to lose. Dispel. Okay. 1, 2. Let's see if it works out. Another Dispel or Hydro Blast? Okay. Lucky. Flame Slash. Let's get rid of Flame Slash because I think Chain Lightning is just better because we can just target him. Maybe we want to have some Forge Devils. Oh, it's okay like that. It's so nice that our creatures have haste. Let's see what he does. Maybe he just boards out Dispel because we don't have too many instant spells. Just 6 of them, I think. Let's see what happens. 1-1 against Peregrine Drake. The Peregrine Drake is such a nice deck because you have so many options. And we are okay. Yes, keep. This hand is okay. We have the one drop. We have the cohort or the shred freak. And we have a burn spell. Nice. Let's cast cohort. And next turn we can just use the Shred Freak or the other cohort. I will play Shred Freak because it deals 2 damage no matter if he just burns away the cohort. Let's see if it works out. So he gains another life through the cliffs, which is actually a factor in matchups like that. And we draw 2 money lands.
way too many lands. Does he have a Hydro Blast here? If he has one, I would use it. Or just Lightning Bolt. Both spells are pretty bad for us. Okay. It's nice to have enough land to carve out, but this number of lands is way too much. Or way too high. Let's say it like that. I guess he should have a creature now here, a blocker. If he has a blocker, we have to use our Fire Blast. No, he just digs for answers. There's a Preordain or Ponder or whatever he plays. I think he plays Preordain. Yep, there we go. And he's trying to find either a land or a burn spell to get rid of the freak. Let's see what happens. Forgotten Cave. Very interesting choice. I wouldn't play Forgotten Cave in this deck. One. And two. I think it's better to play the card now just because we want to deal as much damage as possible. And he's got just one mana left here, which might be a burn spell against a freak. Let's see. I will play the burn spell now. No, no burn spell. Hydro Blast even. Oh, shiny. Okay. It's the third turn in this game, and we still and we only have dealt about 2 damage or 4 damage to him. This is bad. Very bad. Okay. There is the Seagate Oracle, which we have to kill now. Just to have the ground open here. And in the next turn we just play the Conscript to attack for 4. And we have him down to 14 only. And there is actually, what is that? Lightning Bolt. Oh, too bad. Should have played it in our turn. So he's got another removal, I suppose. I think. And no removal spell. He's down to 4 cards, which is not bad for him. He's got 5 cards now. And I think there is going to be a Peregrine Drake now. No Drake time. What is that? 2 mana. There's no spell in his deck that is 2 mana. There has to be a 3 mana. Oh, there we go. And there is the Seagate Oracle. As soon as it comes into play, I'll play Lightning Bolt as an answer. Yep. And now we have to find a creature card to actually attack with the Conscript. If you don't find any creature card, we cannot attack. And a good creature would be a dash creature. No, no dash creature. A creature for a 1 or 2 mana. Best one would be like the Freak or the Cohort to find. Let's see what happens. Bushwrecker is good as well. If he doesn't have a counter spell, we are going to win this one. And there is a counter spell. Ah, too bad. This was such a nice top deck here. 4 times 3. 12 damage. This would have been nice. Eleven damage. Bushwrecker only deals 2. So he's down to 8. We have to draw creatures, non-lands. And have to hope that he doesn't play any Drake here. And there's a Drake. On the boiler works, so let's press F6 and see if he comes into his combo, which he possibly can, because he just, yeah, there's a Drake, which is a good blocker. Let's see what happens. If he doesn't, oh, there's a Preordain. Now he's sticking for removal spells. If he has a removal spell that he can use, we are in a pretty bad spot. He can even go for a flicker, flickering Swiftwater Cleaves and the Drake, maybe. I'm not sure. So he is thinking. Swag Warrior. Let's see what happens. Maybe he's thinking about compulsive research if he wants to play it now. There we go. I will play it now if I were him. Oh, he doesn't want to. He could even flicker. No, nothing. Oh no! I pressed through my attacker's face. Oh, so bad. I was thinking it was the end of his turn, and I pressed F2 and couldn't play the familiar. Oh, this is so bad. Bad luck. So I just missed one turn. I was time walked by the program here. Too bad. So this will cost us the game because we could have attacked with all of our creatures, and now he's got a removal spell. And he can start going off. There's a Flame Slash. Best removal spell. I know it's a good game, I think. Is it? Let's play the familiar. Get it. Counter it. There we go. Still attacking. Down to 7. And then we have to draw a line for dashing that one. Oh, we are losing this one badly. There's another Drake. And this is good game. What is that? Is it the Oracle or the Compulsive Research? I would say it's the Compu- No. 4 mana, what is that? Flicker. But why should he play Flicker? No. What is that? Yeah, we lost by misplay. Archaeomancer for what? Does he want to get? I would get the Seagate Oracle. No, can't counterspell. Okay. But he still has to take me down to. What's it? Heal Cutter. Cast with dash. Let's cast into the counterspell. We don't have any option. We have to make him play his counterspell. Okay. Two more burn spells. Or 3 burn spells. Let's see what happens. What is that? Is it a removal? No, it's a cave. A land, come on, play a land. It's a preordain. Nice top deck. But that's magic. You have to get your cards. Or you just draw your cards. And usually you will find good cards. Put a card on bottom and one of on top. So he has either a counter spell or removal or even a flicker in his hand. Is it another Drake? Archaeomancer again. I would get Preordain or Hydro Blast. Let's get Hydro Blast. Or is it counter spell again? But he doesn't have a land here. Interesting. Okay. What is that card? Attack, he's double blocking. If I were him, I would double block you at this point of the game. Using both mancers. Easy decision. Yep. Okay. So he's got the counterspell, and now it's a Seagate Oracle, yep. Yeah, as soon as it has control about the board and the game, it's hard to win against UR Peregrine Drake. Down to 10. And no, we don't have any chance of winning this one. Counterspell. Yes, if you like so. Okay, I have to concede. GG's. Concede game. We cannot win here anymore. Very well played. Not by us, but.